celebrate this feast of St. Irenaeus, let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And our Mass intention today. I apologize. We'll get the right day. For all priests living and deceased. So we celebrate the sacred mysteries. Let's recall those times. We have not loved the Lord with all our heart and all our soul, and we have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sin. Bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who called the bishop, St. Irenaeus, to confirm true doctrine and the peace of the church, grant, we pray, that through his intercession, that being renewed in faith and charity, we may always be intent on fostering unity and concord. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Abraham and the men who had visited him by the terebinth of Mamre set out from there and looked down towards Sodom. Abraham was walking with them to see them on their way. The Lord reflected, "Shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? Now that he is to become a great and populous nation, and all the nations of the earth are to find blessing in him. Indeed, I have singled him out, that he may direct his children and his household after him, to keep the way of the Lord by doing what is right and just, so that the Lord may carry into effect for Abraham the promise he made before him." Then the Lord said, "The outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is so great, and their sin so great, that I must go down and see whether or not their actions fully correspond to the cry against them that comes to me. I need to find out." While the two men walked on fire toward Sodom, the Lord remained standing before Abraham. Then Abraham drew near to him and said, "Will you sweep away the innocent with the guilty? Suppose there were 50 innocent people in the city. Would you wipe out the place rather than spare it for the sake of the 50 innocent people within it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to make the innocent die with the guilty, so that the innocent and the guilty would be treated alike. Should not the judge of all the world act with justice?" The Lord replied, "If I find 50 innocent people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Abraham spoke up again, "See how I am presuming to speak to my Lord, though I am but dust and ashes? What if there are 5 less than 50 innocent people? Will you destroy the whole city because of those 5? He answered, "I will not destroy if I find 45 there." But Abraham persisted, saying, "What if only 40 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it for the sake of 40. Then Abraham said, "Let not my Lord grow impatient if I go on. What if only 30 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it if I can find the 30 there." Still Abraham went on, Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? He answered, I will not destroy for the sake of the 20. But he still persisted, please let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10 there? He replied, for the sake of those 10, I will not destroy it. The Lord departed as soon as he had finished speaking with Abraham, and Abraham returned home. The word of the Lord. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. The Lord is kind and merciful. He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful. Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever. The Lord is kind and merciful. Not according to our sins does he deal with us. Does he requite up according to our crime? For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness towards those who fear him. The Lord is kind and merciful.
Thing we always don't like. It's called change. reading from Genesis this morning between the dialogue of Abraham and God, you know. And it's the whole call about who is innocent and who's guilty. And as we hear the reading that was proclaimed, it's, well, who's innocent and who's guilty? You know, as a young priest, we went into school, at that time, and this was in, you know, late 80s, early 90s, the kids were asking, well, who gets to go to heaven? Who's in and who's out? Yeah, right? Who's in God's grace and who's out? Who's innocent and who's guilty? At some point, my brothers and sisters, we're all guilty. Through human sin, through human error. And we get out of the wrong way, because it even said it in the reading in Genesis, going on, you know, the way of the Lord. I forgot how it was said. Here we go. It's in the second and third verse. Abraham was walking with them to see them on their way, right? So sometimes we go on the way of innocent, and sometimes we go on the way of guilty, but sometimes we go on the way of guilty and not the way of innocent. You know, it's called sin of omission. It's not so much what you did, it's what you didn't do, right? And so what way are we going? And so the way, here's the word today, everybody, humility. To be a humble disciple of the Lord, including present company. So we're called to live a humble life going on the way of Christ, realizing that at times we're on that innocent way, that road, that other shore, right? But sometimes we're guilty. Because we have to be careful. If we think we're innocent and we lack humility, then it all becomes about us. It's not about following Jesus in everyday lives. So let us pray that we may grow in having a humble heart for the Lord. Together with one voice, let our bring our prayers to our loving and merciful God, that bishops, priests, and religious leaders may be filled with spiritual wisdom and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord. That our merciful and gracious Lord may guide policymakers in protecting the dignity and sanctity of human life from conception and natural death. We pray to the Lord. That the Holy Spirit may comfort the sick and the dying, let us pray to the Lord. That all our faith community may be conformed to the Spirit of Christ, with a profound heart of humility, with many blessings bestowed upon us, let us pray to the Lord. And for the petitions we hold within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask that you graciously hear and answer our prayers offered through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, root of human hands, it can become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Grant my sisters and brothers that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the sacrifice we offer in joy and with joy on the heavenly birthday of St. Irenaeus bring your glory, O Lord, and instill in us the love of the truth, that we may keep the Church's faith invincible and her unity secure through Christ our Lord. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. In their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all the creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song of adoration. And we, with the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by bringing down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death,
O Lord, and confess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, our spouse, St. Joseph, with the blessed apostles, martyrs, St. Irenaeus, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
days of that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait for blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now let us share with one another sign. Lamb of God,
you can take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you can take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you can take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him. He takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
My Jesus, I believe that you are most present with the Holy Sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never let me be separated from you. Let us pray. Through these sacred mysteries, O Lord, we pray. Give us in your affairs compassion and increase of that faith which brought glory to the Bishop St. Irenaeus, as he maintained it even until death. And may the same faith bring us to you who truly follow it, justification in your sight. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So Genesis teaches us about the innocent and the guilty. Sometimes we are innocent, sometimes we are guilty, but we're never totally innocent, we're never totally guilty. But we're growing to be in love with the Lord, so let us grow in that humble heart this day, as we serve Him in so many ways through serving others. Peace the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Now, mighty God, bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.